Our survey of four routes this morning found overcrowding vastly in excess of the targets insisted on by the Department of Transport. It raises serious questions about British Rail's determination and ability to deal with overcrowding, as recommended in the inquiry into the Clapham disaster 2 years ago. After the Clapham crash, BR agreed specific overcrowding maximums to be achieved from April 1990. They were announced in Parliament and set out in a letter from the former Transport Secretary Cecil Parkinson to the then Chairman Sir Bob Reid. It was agreed that there were to be no more than 35 standing passengers per 100 seated on modern trains with sliding doors. And there were to be no more than 10 standing per 100 seated on elderly slam door trains. Recommendation 60 of the official report into the Clapham train disaster said BR shall ensure train loading criteria are achieved. BR publicly accepted this recommendation. These criteria were blatantly broken on the four routes we analysed today. Route 1, West Ealing to Paddington. The 808 from Greenford was a single coach with 65 seats. At most, there should be 6 standing. 80 were standing. Route 2, Willesden Junction to Euston. The three-coach 810 should have had a maximum of 80 standing. In fact, 119 were without seats. Route 3, Haringey to Moorgate. Instead of the agreed 160, the six-coach 814 had 342 standing passengers. Route 4, Wellington Kent to Charing Cross, the 812. Our researchers could only count 8 of the 10 coaches because of overcrowding. The front 8 coaches should have had a maximum of 78 standing. There were 485 on their feet. We showed these disturbing facts to Shadow Transport spokesperson Joan Ruddock.
After the hidden inquiry into the Clapham rail crash, they committed themselves to putting their house in order and not allowing excessive overcrowding. They even told the minister last August that they were already doing that. Now, they clearly are not, and I guess they will tell us they haven't got enough trains, they haven't the capacity to provide more services to meet demand. If that is the case, and I believe it is, then government must give them more money.
British Rail say new trains on order for 2 of the 4 lines and timetable changes will solve the overcrowding problems. We scrutinise their comments. The West Ealing Paddington line won't be fully equipped with new trains until Christmas 1992. The overcrowding will continue for almost 2 years. The Watford, Euston and Haringey Moorgate routes have no new trains planned as the coaches are relatively modern. Apart from fine-tuning the timetable, no relief is in sight. The Welling Charing Cross line won't have new trains until the end of 1992. But even then there's a problem. The present trains are 10 coaches long. The 1992 trains are designed to run in either 8 or 12 coach formations. But because Dartford Station, their starting point, has only room for 10 coach trains, the new 1992 trains will actually run with 8 coaches, 2 fewer than at present, until Dartford is extended in mid-1994.
It's like travelling on a cattle truck. I think that if everyone's sitting down, then it would be much safer, because if there is any accidents, then at least we're cushioned by the seats instead of going head over heels on top of everyone, banging our heads on the ceilings, etc.
A danger to passengers?
Definitely.
At that point, British Rail tried to prevent my colleague Mike Pearce from recording the public's views.
Do you think we should be able to film these sort of conditions, everybody?
Yes! Yes. Absolutely, yes.
Don't you think with so many people standing, safety is being put at risk?
No, I don't agree with that. It is obviously, if you've got a car with 4 passengers in and you're involved in an incident, you've got 4 possible passengers that can be injured, whereas if it's only 1, you've only got 1. And that same equation applies on loaded trains.
We told British Rail about our findings, suggesting they've not met targets agreed after the Clapham tragedy. They declined to put up a spokesman to comment on all the routes we travelled. But they said new trains will solve overcrowding. But many lines have no new trains planned, and some of those with new trains will have fewer seats. The future looks even more overcrowded unless BR is prepared to ask the government for more money for extra trains. Simon Neave with Network Southeast Commuters for Thames News.